And ever since the Easter attacks, a bitter political fight has broken out in the country. The government of Sri Lanka is facing relentless attacks from the opposition. We all spoke to opposition leader Namal Rajapakse today, who blamed the divisions within the government for the lapses. Here are some excerpts from that exclusive conversation.
With me is Mr. Namal Rajapakse. He is a member of parliament in Sri Lanka. Welcome to Vyond once again. And my first question to you is, 1 week, more than a week since the Easter attacks, do you believe that Sri Lanka is now safe? The government has been able to secure your country?
Well, see, the forces are doing their level best. You know, if you look at last 8 days, they have been very active and acting very fast on information they get. And public have been very cooperative. Mm-hmm. And we see on TV, we hear from the security forces that how the public shares information. But as to the government side, you know, we don't have any faith on the president, the prime minister, how they act before the incident, mm-hmm. during the incident, or the after the incident.
Today, the U.S. ambassador to Sri Lanka has said that they still have intelligence of more attacks possibly in the days ahead. At a time like this, what can you as a leader also do? You've raised your concerns. You've said that the government needs to come together. But beyond that, what do you want to do?
See, we will work with the organizations. We will work with the civil and the military organizations and also with the community to bring back normalcy through life. To the people of Sri Lanka. The Sri Lankan people have to get back to their normal lives. I was meeting my local leaders today and political organization in my constituency. You know, people are not moving away, moving out of their house, because people are scared, because they don't have confidence in the government, that they will look after them, that the government can make people safe. So people have to come back to their normal life, and the normals have to be settled, and normals have to be brought to the country.
I'm just playing the devil's advocate. Many would say that at a time when your country is going through this crisis, the fact that you're saying all of this and blaming the government, that the fact that your uncle has announced his run for president, is also political opportunism. How do you respond to that?
See, it's not that he announced it. He said he's ready for it. So it is up to the party to decide who's going to be the candidate. Who's going to be the candidate is not decided by myself or my father or my uncle. It is our party who decides it. It is our people who decide it. And this is not the time to talk about who's going to be the candidate. Anyone can say that they are ready for the elections, but candidacy should be decided when the elections are called.
No, but also blaming the government at a time like this, do you think that it also weakens their morale?
See, there's nothing to weaken in this government, and we're not blaming the government. But we are telling what the government is saying. It is a government minister who said his father knew beforehand. It's not I am who is saying. It's not Namal Rajapakse who is saying that he is responsible. But the government is saying. The government ministers are saying. The cabinet is saying. So when they blame themselves, and when they don't take any sort of action, what else can we do? Next elections, there is time for that. Let's do
it. Are you going to ask for an early election, because the government is in disarray and the country needs a stable, decisive government?
See, the parliament should have been dissolved then and there when we dissolved it. If it was dissolved at that time and gone for a parliament election, this would have never happened. I'm talking about October.
Yeah.
Right? Then and there we would have gone for election. But now, today or tomorrow, on this next 72 hours or next 14 days, is not the time to talk about election. But definitely, if this government has some sort of courtesy, they should have resigned by now.